congregation please stand? The hymn, And Can It Be?
Live to ourselves, and we do not die to ourselves. If we live to the Lord, and if we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, so that he might be Lord of both the dead and the living. May the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ be praised. In his great mercy, by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, He gave us new birth into a living hope, the hope of an inheritance reserved in heaven, which nothing can destroy or spoil or wither. As a father has compassion for his children, so the Lord has compassion for those who fear him. As a mother comforts her child, so I will comfort you, says the Lord. He will feed his flock like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom. We will not have you ignorant, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus, our Lord. Eternal God, our Heavenly Father, you love us with an everlasting love and can turn the shadow of death into the light of a new dawn. Help us now to wait upon you with reverent and submissive hearts. In the silence of this hour, speak to us of eternal things, that with patience and the comfort of your holy word, we may embrace and hold fast the blessed hope of eternal life, which you have given us in your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Please sit. My mother would not be pleased if I didn't say good evening. Good evening, congregation. We move to the tributes for this evening, and I will begin by sharing with you a poem written by our own Andrew Allen. It's entitled, She Had to Ride. When duty called, she had to ride, competing with males on every side. To join that rank, it needed skills, and in this line, she had some spills. Delivering mail, she had to ride, to reach the poor and those with pride. Like in our Savior's earthly time, her pilgrimage was the postal line. She rode districts and became known by every occupant of each home. The pets they had resisted her job. She had to ride from chasing dogs. Her service too was for the Lord. Through Sunday school, she passed his word. Whenever efforts had seemed to tire, her pressing will was God's desire. Her faith was evident in worship song, which helped her task through harvest time. This relationship with Christ has lasted long. Her bell has rung, she answered the chime. Her evening lights got blurred and dimmed by cruel forces that moved within. Her earthly frame could not resist. God made his call, he saw it fit. She now takes flight for higher things, where moving always depends on wings. New shores in which she now can glide. On earth's rough surface, she had to ride. May she rest in peace.
That's good.
On the behalf of Sherborne New Testament Church of God, Sherborne community, and the Early Birds Walkers, we extend our deepest sympathy to the family, friends, and all who are present and can hear us. This tribute, we know she loved worship, it was just mentioned. So we just want to worship God and give him glory for her life. To be praised. He is Alpha and Omega. And we know our sister enjoyed many different choruses, and she led them right here in this church. Every Sunday as I will pass, I would hear her voice, and I know that she was worshiping the Lord. So we're just going to share a couple of them with you this evening in her honor. Hallelujah. I'm going on, that's all I know. I'm going on, that's all I know. I'm going on to that city where mansions are prepared for me. I'm going on, that's all I know. I'm going on, that's all I know. I'm going on to that city where mansions are prepared for me. My mind, Jesus is mine. Mine when I'm weary, mine when I'm dreary. Mine, you know, Jesus is mine. Jesus is always mine. I want to see him someday. I want to see him someday. When my heart is filled with rapture, I'm gonna see him someday. All the way to Calvary, he went for me. He went for me. He went for me. All the way to Calvary, he went for me. And now he sets me free. Although I had so many, many sins, but Jesus took them all away and he pardoned me. Although I had so many, many sins, but Jesus took them all away and he pardoned me. Me never get weary yet. Me never get weary yet. Me never get weary praising the Lord. Me never get weary yet. Oh no, me never get weary. Me never get weary yet. We never get weary praising the Lord. We never get weary yet. Oh yes, sit down, you know me can't sit down. Sit down, you know me can't sit down. Sit down, you know me can't sit down. We got Jesus in my soul and me can't stand up. Stand up, you know me must stand up. Stand up, you know me must stand up. Stand up, you know me must stand up. Me got Jesus in my soul and I must stand up. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We give thanks to the Lord this evening. Amen. For our dear sister.
The song I'm going to sing is Hear My Voice.
Forgiveness finds you. Hear my voice. You're always known. Sing my name to the morning. And when the golden sun goes down, I will be with you. I'll never leave you. Hear my voice and rest in me. So rejoice in the knowing I will conquer all your fears. Trust and listen with faith of children. Hear my voice, oh come to me. Hear my voice, hear me calling in the wind across the sea. For I have written your name in heaven. Hear my voice, come to me.
John. The third item of tribute will be done by John Carrington.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
This tribute is on behalf of Mita. This is Mount Tabor Theater and Arts. Marcia was a very active member of this group, and we usually perform a Good Friday play every Good Friday here at Mount Tabor, and those plays were written by Mr. Anthony Hinkson, and Mr. Hinkson also wrote this tribute, which I'm going to do this afternoon. The gifts of righteousness, virtue, readiness, recall, Marcia Mellows, you openly portrayed them all. The gifts of meekness, kindness, tolerance that made you stand more than 10 feet tall. The hearts of fellow worshipers confirm you possess them all. The gift of that sweet smile, longer than the mile, and pleasant disposition, stronger than any fortress wall, Marcia Mellows possess them all. We surely will.
We surely will miss our thoughtful sister, busy looking even more so while she was cooking. Fixed in our memory, her caring, her selfless sharing, her meaningful chat, helpful in so many ways, her leadership in prayer and praise.
All these gifts left for us here, great and small, to display proudly on our wall. Thank you, Marcia. The angels in heaven, up there too, in unison, applauding you for a job well done as a Wonder Woman.
A blessed mom, hold the fort till we come.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
My name is Stephen Streets. The reason I'm here today is because I'm a messenger. I was asked to relay a message about Marcy's life to you all. And I probably obliged. Now, I know Marcia T as Marcy, so I am asking permission to call her Marcy as I go along. Permission granted. The first time I met Marcy, Marcy had some energy about, positive energy about 101 Celsius. And you know the heat I'm talking about. So the old people will say like, my heart checked to her, and her heart checked to me. So we had a bond of over 30 years. And in that 30 years, you know, a generation is 25 years old. A generation in there. And if you ask me to describe Marcy in one sentence, I would say Marcy was a gem. And if you press me to continue, I would say Marcy was the typical 1940 woman. I'm not 1940 because I can't or shoot socks and her heel shoes or eating food at the door, I'll just kill it with the food. We talking about a humble lady. A lady who never hang a hat above her head, put it on her head. We talking about a loyal, honest, and hardworking lady.
Speak it in, Mike.
We are speaking about a respectful lady with good conduct, impeccable deportment, loving and caring, and a lady who loved God and her church. If you strike a conversation with Marcy, you will never hear Marcy answer yes or no. It will be either yes please or no please. Yes sir or no ma'am. And if you call home, she will never say hello. It's a pleasant good morning, a pleasant good afternoon. And if you ask Marcy to do anything for you, she will never say no. It used to be no problem. No problem. And I can give you a simple example that you may take it for joke. Let's say you ask Marcy to bring 10 sheets of garbage from town when she comes home. And you know that she ride in a motorcycle. So you sitting down wondering, how she ain't get this galvanized up here. But Marcy then put the galvanized upon a truck, the motorcycle upon a truck, and bring it in Brentfield. That's Marcy. That's the Marcy that I knew. And that's the Marcy that all of us here appreciated. Now, I can deliver the message as was instructed. That was my tribute to Marcy. Marcia Emile Tate Mellers was born on the 14th of May 1965. Yeah. And she was the last daughter. Yeah, I got it right. Yeah. Yeah. She was the last daughter of four children to Mildred and Arthur Tate. She was also the late wife of Police Constable Ernest Mellers, who happened to be my brother. She was the mother of Marlon and Jaleesa, grandmother of 2.5 children. The 0.5 is that, my information is that the third will soon come. So Louisa is 0.5 for now. She attended Mount Tabor Mixed School, Grantley Adams Secondary School. Like most young people on leaving school, she went into various jobs until one day she was called to service as a public servant in the postal services. Marcy was a public servant and not the typical one, a dedicated. Sometimes Marcy had more bills paying for people than meals delivering. Take it as I tell you, without any cost. People who can reach, like them power, waterworks, NPC. People who can even get to the post office. Because of their circumstances, Marcy was the bill payer. And she worked at the Postal Services for 33 plus years. Marcy was very pleasant, mannerly, and always willing to help in whatever way she can. During this period of her life, this pleasantness was also seen in her church life. Marcy was a God-fearing woman and an avid church member. I could attest to that. Avid church. She was involved in almost every aspect of this church. Workshops, group-like theaters, Sunday school, youth groups, women's fellowship, the choir, call it. Whatever the church had, Marcy was in. Marcy was like salt in the pot, in everything. Whatever the church had here, Marcy was involved. And involving positively. She was also the fun and joy of the West Jam group, where she was all the planner and the fun activities. Marcy had a full life of fun and excitement. A dresser, we know her. Mm-hmm. A dresser. Perfumes, jewelry. And don't talk about the home. The house. And your favorite color was green. Green, everything was about green. Even a toothbrush. Marcy must got green. Curtains, don't talk. Well, later on I will tell you about the curtain part. Curtains for every occasion, Christmas, Easter, sometimes just wake up and feel I can change curtains. That was Marcy. And discipline, she always tell her children, keep the house clean. When you go to school, behave yourself, because they don't walk come down there and embarrass you all. And she would have. Tell them as you fall down when you out there, when you get home, your bed got to be makeup. So you will go in a clean bed, the people that bring you home, we see that the house clean and the bed clean. Cooking, I used to call her Chef Boyardee, the chef. Prepare any meal, and if you go up Marcy ain't want you to leave unless you find something for you to eat. She can cook it, and she can delay you to when she done cook it, even if it's macaroni and corn. Because she gave you something to eat. That is Marcy. Conkeys. A strict parent, as I told you, she always warned Marlon and Jalisa go to school and be here because I can come down and embarrass you. And you know young people don't want to get embarrassed at school. You want your mother to come and beat you at school. She met Ernest. One year was in. Ernest used to live in her postal district, and they met. And then here, see, I hear a joke, she tell me, never tell nobody till she pass. Her first day with Ernest, they were going to Glow Cinema. And you know the bus is going to pass by the cinema. Marcy was in the bus, and Marcy said, I hope that this man is an ugly man, you know. So Marcy said, when the bus get by Glow up and she stop it, and she looked, she said, this girl looking at me. She didn't show her. She went down by Weymouth, walked back, and I could tell you the rest is history. The rest is history. She always tell me, don't tell nobody the secret till when she did. Nanan, her grandchild, she will truly miss her. That I had an opportunity to see that little girl and her grandmother, and that she called her Nana. Don't care where Marcy Swing, Nana was there. But she loved, Marcy loved people, so special love would always be for children. I got special love for granddaughter, so I know special love be a gift to children. Marcy would always meditate on mornings in the bathroom, Bible. Mary, who is my wife, bonded with Marcy, and there's a wife-in-law. Mary Penn, as Marcy, as I affectionately call her, met to her husband Ernest. And we became very close friends up to the day she died. Marcy was very humble, loving, hardworking. She loved fashion, fancy house cooking. She was a good listener. I was never judgmental. She loved her children and granddaughters. Her love for God was untouchable. And Christmas is not going to be the same before her. Oh, she loved the decorating. There's so much more I would love to say about my friend, but time would not permit it. My friend, you will always be in my heart. Rest in peace and rest in glory. And St. Tomia, a friend-in-law, Ben, Marcy was my friend for many years. We would hear each other at least twice a week, and boy, she loved Christmas and her God. There was nothing that could come between her and these two things. I'm truly going to miss hearing her voice on the telephone every morning saying a blessed good morning. May she rest in peace, rise in glory. Rest in peace, Marcy, my friend. Thank you.
My hope is built on nothing less
than Jesus and his righteousness. Let's stand and sing. Chapter 21, reading the first 7 verses, Brother Robert Howard.
A reading from the Word of God, recorded in the Revelation, chapter 21, verses 1 through 7. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God, out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. This is the word of the Lord.
Thank you, the Lord. The second lesson taken from John's Gospel, chapter 14, reading verses 1 to 6. It will be read by granddaughter Amaya Tate, apologies, and she may have a few words to say otherwise.
The Bible lesson is taken from John chapter 14. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas saith unto him, Lord, we know not whither thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Here ends the reading.
Have a selection by the choir.
Thank you, choir. Marcy would start clapping the choir, so please clap them for me. As part of our meditation this evening, I'm going to ask Marcy's sister, Judy, to read a short tribute, and I have Amaya's word. No. While Robert set up Judy, I read Amaya. Amaya, it's okay? Okay. My Nan was a loving granny. She was my favorite person. She cooked her best food, worked hard, and looked after me, spent all her money on me. But now she is in a better place, watching over me from the clouds, smiling happily with Granddad Ernest. I know she wanted me to be proud. She is proud of me. And she wanted me to be the best in everything I do. I am perfect, Nan, even though you are not here with us. Personally, I can hear you saying, "Congratulations, Amaya, love you," with a beautiful smile and a warm hug. I promise you, Nan, I will make you proud. Auntie, Daddy, and I will take care of the things that remind us of you. The good time we spend together will be treasured. Sleep well, Nan, Nanny, Nana. You will always be my granny. Gone too soon. Love, Amaya Tate.
My last request. Please do not say that I give up. I just say I give in. Don't say I lost the battle, for it was God's war to lose or to win. Please do not say how good I was or what I did my best. I say I tried to do what's right, to give the most I could, not less. Please do not give me wings or halos. That is what God to do. I want no more than I deserve, no less, no extras, just my dues. Don't be concerned about me now. I am well with God. I made it home. Don't talk about what could have been done, for it's over and done. Just see to all my family needs. The battle has been won. When you draw a picture of me, don't draw me as a saint. I done wrong. I done good. I use all the paint. Don't just bright the light tones, just use the gray and dark. In fact, don't put me down on canvas, paint me in your heart. Don't just remember the good times, but remember some bad. And if you do something that I have, one last request. Thank God for my soul is resting. Thank God for blessing me. And thank God for those who love me. Praise God who loves me best.
Thank
you. That's my tribute to my sister. And I want her to know, and I want everybody to know, I had loved her and I will continue to love her until we meet again. Rest in peace, my dear sister. Thank you.
I have mixed emotions. And so that's what I'm placing as the theme for today. In Psalm 116 and verse 8, it says, for thou hast delivered my soul from death, my eyes from tears, and my feet from falling. Anytime a group of people gather around the body of a Christian, around the body of one who loves Christ, there are mixed emotions. This is the subject that I will look at, and I'm going to take shorter than Mr. Street, who did the eulogy. Hear me well. There are emotions of sorrow because Marcia, our loved one, has departed in death. Any human finds it difficult to give up a loved one. What Streaky didn't tell you was that Ernest had on a pink shirt and Marcia decided she ain't bothering with this fella. A pink t-shirt. I learned that. I knew that. She docked in the bus, really, because she didn't want to go out with a fella in a pink shirt. Often, the survivors have seen their deceased loved one suffered long and much in life, and perhaps just prior to death. We have seen Marcia. First, the last time was Mother's Day, when her daughter was named the youngest mother in church. And the baby was in church. So you had four generations in church that day. The baby's great-great-grandmother. And the usher thought the gift was going to grand-gran. We saw Marcia. But as she said to Jalissa and Marlon, "I am ready to go home," I said to them both, because she made up her mind to go home, we don't have to worry anymore. We observe a gradual failing of health. But we become anxious. Death is inevitable. Now that death has occurred, there is assurance that Marcia is in an eternal place of rest and freedom from eternal troubles, earthly troubles. We are the ones fighting up with which mask we should wear and whether we wear it or not. We are the ones that are fighting up with COVID and wondering why everybody don't stay their distance. We are the ones that are behind, just hoping that this stupid thing COVID will go away. But not for Marcy. Marcy sits there or lies there with no cares in the world. Not anymore. Yet, even with this assurance, there is still sorrow in seeing her go. Jan couldn't finish the tribute sent by Mr. Hinkson. Mr. Hinkson would tell Jan, "Go back and read it properly. And then you can come down here and cry." Or at rehearsal time, just as how Admiral Bonsover, the baptismal font, every lead person in the play bounce it over. It's still standing. Marcy must be laughing and saying, "What are you disturbing the thing for?" Any friend has grief in the departure of a friend. This friendship, for me personally, she was my riding partner, because anytime I'm going to a service, Mosso Harvest, or missionary, I ain't coming back to St. John by myself. So there was always Sister Cummins and Marcia. Someone called when she passed that, you know, don't have no riding partner. Marcia, a fellow member of this church, a neighbor. But a friendship has been established. It is a traumatic experience to part. But there are emotions of joy because of eternal welfare of the deceased, of Marcia, who is a Christian. When she ready to go home, Jalissa, that wasn't to Sherborne, that was to be with her master. You see, death for a believer, death for a Christian, is a glorious thing. You saw how she lay there in comfort and peace. You see that tranquil look on her face. Well, it is a transformation from a sickly, frail, suffering body to a glorious body. The Bible gives the assurance of the wonderful state now, as was read in the book of Revelations, chapter 21, verses 1 to 4. Death for a Christian is a blessed experience. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead which die in the Lord. From henceforth, yea, said the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, and their works do follow them. The passage gives assurance of another life after this one. Jesus told the sister of Lazarus, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And have hope towards God, which they themselves also allowed, that there shall be a resurrection of the dead, both of the just and the unjust. The last chorus that Marcia stood up and raised right at the back there in her green dress, because green was the color that day at church. She said, she shouted, tell me, who has the final say? Tell me, Jehovah, turn my life around. Help me sing, Jehovah, turn my life. We take a way where there is no way, Jehovah. She knew that, and I hope that we can know that. Why? We have emotions of joy because of the promises of God. The psalmist said it in Psalm 49 and verse 15, but God will redeem my soul from the power of the grave, for he shall receive me. Verily, verily, I say unto you, the hour is coming, and now is, when the dead shall hear the voice of the Son of God, and they that hear shall live. Marcia, I ain't got much more to say. we're going to tell you, go on and take your rest. You see, if you are in grief today because of Marcia's death, then do not be ashamed, cry if you want to. Don't wait till you go home, because tomorrow morning a certain fellow on the radio is going to ask you what is on your mind. Cry now, so that tomorrow you can say you feel good, knowing that Marcia, your friend, your loved one, knows God and Jehovah has a final say. Thank God that you have feelings, human feelings. But then also, thank God that God has provided for Marcia in death, and that you now can rest assured. But if you don't have all those feelings, I commend to you the Jesus that I serve, the one that Marcia made her Lord and Savior. And when the children humbugging her, she would sing the hymn, one of those in your bulletin, so that she doesn't hear them while they're speaking. But we are going to join in the next hymn, because we know Jesus Christ, and if we don't, then we will get to know him, the Jesus of Marcia. God bless you, loved ones. Make sure you can say, like Marcia, I'm ready to go home when the time comes. Amen. Let's sing the next hymn.
In Christ Alone.
In Christ Alone. Please stand.
Salon. My hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. His cornerstone.
You're going to leave now. You're going to leave.
As he stands in victory,
life on me, for I am his and he is mine, bought with the precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From life first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man can ever pluck me from his hand till he return. Here in the power of Christ I stand.
Amen. You may be seated, brothers and sisters. We will enter into moments of prayer. And as we enter into moments of prayer, we are always reminded to keep the family in prayer. Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, hear us.
By your human birth, by your obedience and faithfulness, by your prayers and tears, by your agony and passion, by your dying words, by your reconciling death, by your rest in the grave, by your triumphant resurrection, and by your abiding presence,
comfort us, Lord.
Let us together pray the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Most holy and merciful God, the refuge and strength of those who put their trust in you, we thank you for the multitude no one can number whom you have received into your eternal joy. We praise you that you have forgiven them all their sins and that they dwell with you beyond evil and sorrow forever. We thank you also for all to whom amid the trials of this mortal life you give the faith that overcomes the world, who have peace in you and rejoice in the hope of your glory. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
We continue in prayer. Eternal God, before whose face a generation rise and passed away, we bless and praise your name for all who have departed this life in faith, and especially for our late sister, Sister Marcia Tate Mellows. For all your kindness to her throughout her earthly life, we give you thanks, O Lord. We thank you that you, for her, for all sickness and sorrow are ended, and that death in itself is past. Almighty God, may we, inspired by the exalting of your saints, run with patience the race that is set before us, looking to Jesus, the author and perfecter of our faith, so that when this mortal life is ended, we may be gathered with those whom we have loved in the kingdom of your glory, where there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away, through Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen.
Hey, you forget to do the other part. Go ahead.
God of mercies and God of all comfort, You make nothing in vain and love all that you have made. Look in tender mercy on your people in their loss. Enable them to find in you their refuge and their strength, a very present help in trouble. Sustain them and deliver them from bitterness, despair, and doubt of your love. Comfort them in their sadness. Uphold them with your strong love. Help them to face the future without the fear of knowing that they and all whom they love are in your hands, and that nothing in life, not even death itself, can separate any one of us from your love in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Our Father, O God, our Father, by whom you are led through the changes of time to the rest and blessedness of eternity, be near us to comfort and uphold. Make us to know that your people are precious in your sight and that they live evermore with you. As we thank you for Marcia, whose life we shared, may we trust you at this time of parting. Oh God, give us of your strength, that we may take our lives more bravely and seek to be more faithful in duty and more loving and helpful to others, following those who are no longer with us here on earth. And may we, in our turn, find in your great mercy the perfect and unending rest of God, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let us commend Marcia to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer.
Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, by your power, you gave us life, and in your love, you have given us new life in Christ. We entrust Marcia to your merciful keeping, and in the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who died and rose again, that we might enjoy eternal life. Please stand for the benediction. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen. Amen. This service continues at the graveside. We have the members of the postal service will escort the body or take the body out. We will sing that hymn, "Oh, When the Saints Go Marching In." When the saints go marching in, I'm gonna go get some more. and number. Ah, when the saints go mad. Let's go. You go. Yeah. Come. Come, Mama. Oh, dear. Watch all the... Oh, dear. The daughter mm-hmm. has one movie to go. You do it. You go ahead. You go ahead because you're going to put on the set your troubled hearts at rest. Trust in God always. Trust also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you. We know that when our earthly frame just allow me to finish, okay then. We know that when our earthly frame is destroyed, we possess a building provided by God eternal in the heavens. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. All who have faith in me shall live, even though they die. No one who lives and has faith in me shall ever die. O death, where is your victory? O death, where is your sting? Thanks be to God who gives the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
we entrusted Marcia to God's merciful keeping, and now we commit her body to the ground in sure and certain hope of the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who died, was buried, rose again for us. To him be glory forever and ever.
Amen.
We continue in prayer. O Father of all, we pray to you for those who, to whom we love but see no longer. Grant them your peace. Let light perpetual shine upon them, and in your loving wisdom and almighty power, work in them the good purpose of your perfect will. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, Father of all mercies and giver of all comfort, deal graciously with all who mourn at this time, that casting every care upon you, they may know the consolation of your love. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
O Lord, support us all the day long of this earthly life, until the shadows lengthen and the evening comes, the busy world is hushed, the fever of life over, and our work done. Then, O Lord, in your mercy, grant to us and to those we love safe lodging, holy rest, peace at the last, through our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Rejoicing in the communion of saints, we thank you for all your servants who have departed in the faith, the great cloud of witnesses by whom we are encompassed, who in every age have loved you in life and continued faithful unto death, especially those most dear to our own hearts. Give us grace with them to follow you, and bring us at the last to those things which eye has not seen, nor ear heard, which you have prepared for them that loved you. Amen. And the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with you, remain with you, and abide with you, now and forevermore. Amen. We invite the family to come at this time and to lay their roses as a final tribute. Our first hymn by the graveside. What a fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness and what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place when we all get to heaven.
Sing the wondrous love of Jesus, sing his mercy and his grace. In the mansions bright and blessed, he'll prepare for us a place when we all.
standing on the promises of Christ, my King. Through eternal ages, let his praises ring and glory in the highest. I will shout and sing, for I am standing on the promises of God.
Standing on the promises of Christ, my King. Through eternal ages, let his praises ring. Glory in the highest, I will shout and sing. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises, I cannot fall. Listening every moment to the Spirit's call. Resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of Christ my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God.
When the roll is called up yonder, for when the trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more, and the morning breaks eternal, bright and fair, when the saved on earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. Peace like a river attendeth my way, when sorrows like sea billows roll. Whatever my lot you have taught me to say, it is well, it is well. with my soul.
Yeah.
The family members will now lay their final tribute of flowers and wreaths, followed by extended family, friends, and well-wishers.